हेलो एवरीबॉडी, आई एम डॉक्टर कार्तिक राठी, जूनियर रेजिडेंट इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ रेडियो डायग्नोसिस एट कस्तूरबा मेडिकल कॉलेज मणिपाल। द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज़ रोल ऑफ सीटी कोरोनरी एनजियो इन इवेल्युएशन ऑफ पोस्ट सीएबीजी और परक्यूटेनियस इंटरवेंशन कॉम्प्लिकेशंस। सीएबीजी ग्राफ्ट इज प्लेस टू इंक्रीज ब्लड फ्लो टू द मायोकार्डियम इन केसेज ऑफ कोरोनरी आर्टरी डिजीज। ग्राफ्ट्स आर्टीरियल और वीनस आर ईदर सूचर्ड और एवी कनेक्टर डिवाइसेस कैन बी यूज्ड। आर्टीरियल ग्राफ्ट्स हैव बेटर पेटेंसी रेट्स देन वीनस ग्राफ्ट्स। स्क्रीनिंग ऑफ ग्राफ्ट्स फॉर पेटेंसी इन द अर्ली दैट इज लेस देन 1 month एज वेल एज लेट दैट इज मोर देन 1 month पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव पीरियड्स आर असेंशियल। पेटेंसी ऑफ ग्राफ्ट्स कैन बी असेस्ड ईदर बाय कथेटर एनजियोग्राफी और सीटी एनजियोग्राफी। सीटी एनजियोग्राफी इज प्रेफर्ड ओवर पर्क्यूटेनियस एनजियोग्राफी टू असेस्ट ग्राफ्ट पेटेंसी since it is minimally invasive and better tolerated. We present 4 cases of patients who underwent coronary angio bypass graft surgery who were later evaluated for complications of the same on presentation with chest pain or dyspnea. Retrospective ECG gated CT coronary angio was performed at our institution using Philips incisive 128 slice CT with a prefix standard protocol. Acquisition bolus tracking technique from cardiac base to thoracic inlet, that is lung apex, with inclusion of the subclavian arteries, performed in a caudal to cranial direction. Single breath hold at mean heart rate of 60 to 70 beats per minute. Non-iodinated contrast material was injected through an 18 to 20 gauge cannula at the rate of 3 to 4 ml per second. Post-processing, a phase obtained at 75% of the RR interval was reconstructed, from which straight and curved multiplanar reformations were reformatted and used for image interpretation. Other phases were also reconstructed from 10 to 100%. Axial CT images at 75% of the RR interval and curved planar post-process images were performed, predominantly used for image interpretation. Complications can be further divided into early and late complications. Early complications, thrombosis, it is the most common in early post-operative period. There can be graft malposition or kinking, graft spasm, iatrogenic complications such as pericardial effusion or pneumothorax, graft aneurysm, acute occlusion. Late complications can be graft aneurysm or chronic occlusion. Our first case was a patient who had a history of undergoing PCI, stenting of proximal RCA, in view of non-STEMI, presented 12 days later with complaints of breathlessness and orthopnea. CT coronary angio was advised. These are the pre and post contrast axial images of the CT coronary angio. A secular lobulated contrast filled outpouching was noted arising from the segment 1 of RCA proximal to the stent. On coronal and curved planar images of the same, surrounding hematoma was seen, which was suggestive of pseudoaneurysm with surrounding hematoma indenting on the myocardium of right ventricle. These are the straight and 3D reconstructed images of the same, which confirmed the findings. Pseudoaneurysm was noted arising from proximal segment of RCA just proximal to the stent. On follow-up, check coronary angio showed multivessel disease with giant RCA coronary aneurysm. Patient was planned for emergency repair of giant coronary aneurysm. Our second case was a known case of IHD status post coronary angio CABG, who presented with retrosternal chest pain burning type 6 months post-op. These are the SVG2 obtuse marginal graft. This is SVG2 RCA and Lima2 LAD graft. Lima2 LAD graft showed good contrast opacification and caliber. However, SVG2 OM and SVG2 RCA grafts showed proximal segment occlusion just distal to the origin, however, with maintained faint distal contrast opacification. Then SVG2 RCA, there was narrowing at the anastomosis also, but faint contrast opacification was maintained. These are the straight axis views of the same, confirming the findings. On follow-up, patient was diagnosed as non-STEMI. CT coronary angio showed blocked SVG2 D1 graft. Coronary invasive angiogram showed native multivessel disease. Patent Lima2 LAD, SVG2 RCA, PDA, osteoproximal narrowing was seen, with diffuse small vessel occluded SVG2 D1 graft. Invasive angio was not able to visualize the SVG2 OM graft, but it was patent on CT coronary angio. Patient improved with medical management. Our third case was a patient status post CABG to check status of vessels who complained of chest pain. The SVG to obtuse marginal, that is saphenovenous to obtuse marginal venous graft, showed acute bend with mild kinking in the proximal most part. However, rest of the graft showed normal caliber with maintained contrast opacification. There was acute bending with kinking in the proximal most part. Our last case was a patient who underwent CABG for ischemic heart disease 2 years back, presented with generalized weakness since 1 month, dyspnea on exertion, pedal edema, and facial puffiness since 1 week. The SVG to LAD graft was patent and showed good contrast opacification. SVG to RCA graft was also patent, showed few areas of kinking, however, normal contrast opacification. But as LCX graft showed no contrast opacification. On 3D images also, these grafts were seen. On follow-up, coronary angio showed triple vessel disease with blocked LCX graft, which was not visualized on coronary and CT coronary angio. And the patient was planned for medical management and improved with medical management. Coming to the results, out of our 4 patients who had complications on CT coronary angio, all underwent invasive coronary angio and findings were confirmed. SVG to OM graft, which could not be assessed on invasive coronary angio while could be assessed on CT coronary. Mildly attenuated grafts seen on CT coronary angio appeared normal on invasive angio. One patient who underwent repair of coronary aneurysms, while other were managed conservatively. Summarizing, various pathologies affecting coronary artery stents and grafts can be evaluated optimally using CT coronary angio. The knowledge and the of the anatomy and proper planning of the scan are essential for complete evaluation of the coronary arteries and grafts. Various pathologies affecting it can be evaluated optimally by CT coronary angiography. These are my references. Thank you.